This is the structure of abstract factory pattern. We will see how this is implemented in Python source. Here is the class abstract factory. It has methods createProduct1 and createProduct2. They will be implemented in its subclasses. Here is the subclass concreteFactory1 derived from class abstractFactory. Here it implements the method createProduct1. Inside this, it creates the instance object of product1_1 and returns it. Here it implements the method createProduct2. Inside this, it creates the instance object of product2_1 and returns it. So we can see here concreteFactory1 is creating series1 product. product1_1 and product2_1. Here is the subclass concreteFactory2 derived from class abstractFactory. Here it implements the method createProduct1. Inside this, it creates the instance object of product1_2 and returns it. Here it implements the method createProduct2. Inside this, it creates the instance object of product2_2 and returns it. So we can see concreteFactory2 is creating series2 products, product1_2 and product2_2. Here is the class abstractProduct1. It has method display. It will be implemented in its subclasses. Here is the subclass product1_1 derived from class abstractProduct1. Here it implements the method display. Inside this, it just displays this statement. Here is the subclass product1_2 derived from class abstractProduct1, and here it implements the method display, which is just displaying this statement. Here is the class abstractProduct2. It has method display. It will be implemented in its subclasses. Here is the subclass product2_1 derived from class abstractProduct2. Here it implements the method display. Here is the subclass product2_2 derived from class abstractProduct2. Here it implements the method display. Okay, we'll see how all these classes has been used. Here we are creating instance object of concreteFactory1 and assigning it to variable factory1, and then we are calling the method createProduct1 of factory1. So it will go to concreteFactory1 createProduct1. So it will come here, it will create the instance object of product1_1 and returns it. So product1_1 instance object will be assigned to variable prod1, and when the method display is called, it goes to product1_1 display. So it will come here, it will display this statement. Similarly, here we are calling the method createProduct2 of factory1. So it goes to concreteFactory1 createProduct2. concreteFactory1 createProduct2. So product2_1 instance object will be written. So product2_1 instance object will be assigned to prod2, and when the method display is called, it goes to product2_1 display. So it will display this statement. So we can see these statements are used for creating series1 products using concreteFactory1. Similarly, here these statements are used for creating series2 products using concreteFactory2. So here we are creating instance object of concreteFactory2 and we are assigning to variable factory2, and then we are calling the method createProduct1 of factory2. So it goes to concreteFactory2 createProduct1. here, and it returns product 1 underscore 2 instance object. So when the method display is called, it goes to product 1 underscore 2 display. So it will come here, it will display this statement. And here we are calling the method create product 2 of concrete factory 2. So it will come here, it will return product 2 underscore 2 instance object. So product 2 underscore 2 instance object is assigned to product 2 when the method display is called. It comes here and it will display this statement. Okay, we will run this program and we'll see the output. So we can see when the method display is called here, here create product 1 is returning product 1 underscore 1 instance object this. So it goes to product 1 underscore 1 display here, and this will be displayed. And when the display is called here, since create product 2 of concrete factory 1 is returning product 2 underscore 1 object, here, so it goes to product 2 underscore 1 display here, and this is displayed inside product 2 underscore 1 display. And here when the method display is called, it goes to product 1 underscore 2 display as create product 1. Here is returning product 1 underscore 2 object concrete factory 2 create product 1. So it comes here and it displays this. And the last one, it will go to product 2 underscore 2 display as create product 2 of concrete factory 2 is returning product 2 underscore 2 instance object. So it comes here and it will display this statement. So we can see concrete factory 1 is creating series 1 product and using it. And here concrete factory 2 is creating series 2 products, and then we are using it.